North Korean dictator Kim Jong-un recently said his goal is to reach an equilibrium of real force with the United States and dissuade talk of U.S. military action against his regime, and that he wants to finish his nuclear weapons program despite sanctions. Kim's comment comes after North Korea test-fired a ballistic missile over northern Japan for the second time in just a few weeks. North Korea's state-run media released this video, which shows the missile launch along with these photos of Kim Jong-un watching it. The North Korean threat and China's assertiveness in the South China Sea underscore how Japan still relies on the U.S. military for protection, just as it has since the end of World War II. Earlier this month, Defense Secretary Jim Mattis said the U.S. will work with Japan to enhance its missile defenses, and the U.S. commitment to defend Japan remains, quote, ironclad. In tonight's signature segment, NewsHour Weekend special correspondent Amy Gutman reports from the Japanese island of Okinawa on how U.S. bases there are a cause of concern to many residents.
And then on April 1st, at 0530 in the morning.
U.S. Marine Mark Waycaster leads tours of the 1945 Battle of Okinawa every week.
We dropped 4,500 tons of ordnance on that beach.
Okinawa was the bloodiest battle in the Pacific during World War II. 14,000 Americans were killed, as were 150,000 Japanese military and civilians, and U.S. troops never left. The American soldiers have been the cornerstone of the post-World War II pact to protect a demilitarized Japan. U.S. troops deployed from Okinawa to fight the wars in Korea and Vietnam. Soldiers came back for rest and relaxation. The troops also provide economic security. 9,000 Okinawans work on the bases, and many more at businesses supporting them. Emblems of the fused culture are all over the island.
In this area, there were more than 100 bars.
Tomoteru Tamari's family owned a restaurant that thrived during the more lucrative years of the Vietnam War.
And here?
My mother.
My father, he became so prosperous that all of us nine children were able to go to university, thanks to the U.S. base.
But those benefits are outweighed for most Okinawans by a feeling of endless military occupation.
After Japan surrendered in World War II, Okinawa was kept under American military rule for more than two decades. Residents of the island only won the right to elect their own governor in 1968.
Today, there are 29,000 troops on Okinawa, more than half of the 56,000 U.S. troops still stationed in Japan. One of the U.S. military bases, Futenma Air Station, sits in a dense urban area right in the middle of the island. Marine Lieutenant General Lawrence Nicholson is the highest-ranking U.S. military officer on Okinawa. He says today's global threats make the mission here as relevant as ever.
We have China, North Korea, Russia, and the violent extremism that is occurring today in Mindanao of the Philippines. The location here, a couple hundred miles south of Japan, puts us centrally located to be able to respond quickly, very, very quickly to a Korean scenario from here to defense of all of our allies.
Okinawa's location, within 2 hours flight time to the Korean Peninsula, 3 hours to Russia, make it both vulnerable and valuable to the U.S.
Certainly we're concerned about the longer range missiles. Kim Jong-un has launched more missiles in his short time than his father and grandfather combined. So the obsession with weaponizing and delivering nuclear weapons has caused us significant concern.
All right, sir, bleed on brakes.
Japan shares the burden of the costs of U.S. deployment. It pays the U.S. $1.7 billion a year for the protection, about a third of the $5.5 billion the military spends in the whole country. The Japanese government in Tokyo also sends Okinawa funds for hosting the Americans. Despite the government subsidies and spending by military personnel, a majority of Okinawans want the American troops to leave. One of the biggest complaints, nearly 6,000 crimes committed by U.S. military personnel since 1972, according to police records. When three U.S. servicemen abducted and raped a 12-year-old girl in 1995, public outrage soared and propelled talks to reduce troop levels on the island. In 2014, the crime rate for the U.S. military personnel in Okinawa reached a historic low. But last year, residents were reminded of past brutalities when a U.S. military contractor raped and murdered a 20-year-old woman.
How do you explain these atrocities?
You can't explain it. We were as shocked and horrified by the incident as anyone. The fact that it was an American civilian working on a base that had committed this was devastating. We have an obligation to be better.
That pledge is little solace for Kinjo Takamasa. His mother managed a bar near a base in the northern part of Okinawa. In 1974, she died when a U.S. Marine hit her in the head with a brick during a robbery.
I used to think the U.S. military was helping to revitalize our town, but it was an illusion because I became a victim.
6 days a week, protesters gather outside this base to complain about the military presence, including the noise and the safety risks of U.S. aircraft flying above. V-22 Ospreys take off from Futenma Air Station every day. The controversial and accident-prone aircraft takes off like a helicopter and flies like a plane. They cruise over homes, hospitals, and schools. Practically next door, Professor Masaaki Tomochi teaches international relations at the University of Ryukyu.
How regularly do you hear planes taking off and landing?
Every day, from the morning to the nighttime, actually. 6 months ago, one Osprey crashed in Okinawa.
Okinawa Governor Takeshi Onaga is leading the fight to reduce the American military presence.
We depend on security from U.S. military bases in this country. But the Japanese government, they are willing to locate all the bases in Okinawa. I can't tolerate this over-concentration of U.S. bases.
Onaga calls it over-concentration because Okinawa represents less than 1% of Japan's land. Yet 64% of the Japanese land used for U.S. bases is on the island. Since his election 3 years ago, he's tried to block construction in this picturesque, sparsely populated area in the northern part of the island, called Hinoko Bay, where a new base would replace Futenma Air Station.
So what do you see as the solution?
I'd like all Japanese to shoulder the burden of hosting U.S. bases. When I speak with people coming from mainland Japan, I say, why don't you host U.S. military bases in your hometown?
The U.S. has agreed to reduce its presence in Okinawa by relocating 9,000 Marines to bases in Guam, Australia, Hawaii, and other American states. But there's no fixed timeline for that to happen. The military has returned 12,000 acres of land once used for bases and training to the Okinawan government, with 3,000 more acres promised. Professor Tomochi sees more risks than rewards in relocating Futenma Air Station.
You don't see its strategic value.
If the U.S. and Japan think that their potential enemy is China, for example, if China launched missile to U.S. military bases in Japan, including Okinawa, you know, it's useless.
So do you feel more safe or less safe with the military here?
It's less safe. It means we became a target.
Most Okinawans oppose a new airfield in Hinoko Bay, but construction has begun, and the Japanese government is footing the bill. Kinjo Takamasa has been among those protesting the project and its environmental impact.
This is sacred ocean for me, a sanctuary. I became a protester because the U.S. base destroyed nature.
Businessman Tomoteru Tamari, whose father owned that thriving restaurant, is among the minority of Okinawans who support the new airfield, as do local officials, hoping it will revive the area's fortunes.
Some residents who had moved out are starting to move back. There's hope the population will increase and create a better environment for children, better education.
But Okinawa's government says the island would be better off with more private development. It says this town, built on land reclaimed from the U.S. military and now home to an entertainment and shopping complex, has an economic impact 100 times greater than the base that was here before. Okinawans would like to replicate that success, turning more prime real estate used by the military into valuable destinations for commerce and tourism. Like this beach where the U.S. Marines first landed in 1945.